Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I, Vishal Rawat, student manager of River Sabarmati, would like to introduce today's guest. Mr. Manoj belongs to a family which shifted from Sialkot, Pakistan, leaving all their belongings behind, to a small town named Hapur, Uttar Pradesh, and started their life afresh from zero. Thanks to the indomitable spirit of parents and togetherness of family members, that the scarcity of resources could not restrict the education of their children. Mr. Manoj got selected in Uttar Pradesh competitive engineering exam and entered MMM Engineering College, Gorakhpur, and pursued his BE in computer science. After completing his engineering in 1989, he got selected in SSB and was commissioned in Indian Air Force as an SSC officer for signal stream, where he handled ADHS, which is Automatic Data Handling System, to support defense surveillance radar system operations in northern, eastern, and western sectors. After the completion of his SSC tenure in 1995, he moved out in order to utilize his technical as well as managerial skills in the civil life. This was a time when mobile telephony revolution was taking shape in India. He joined the mobile telephony industry through SR Cellphone, Delhi in 1996. Since then, he has grown along with mobile communication growth in India. Having got 20 plus years of rich experience of leading technical teams in geographical circles like Delhi, Haryana, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Goa, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir, Sir has contributed a lot in the growth of the telecommunication services with the cutting edge technology transformation from GSM to LTE. In his current role as a Vice President in Technology and Operations Central Hub, VIL, he is supporting the world's biggest telecom network integration. He is playing a pivot role to enhance operational efficiency along with network growth, cost optimization, and network transformation to enhance end user experience. Sir also takes genuine interest in literary and sports activities such as poetry, reading books, athletics, chess, and cricket. Sir, I request you to kindly enlighten us with your words full of wisdom and experience. Sir, the stage is all yours.
So I am between you and the cricket match. Isn't it? So what do you want me to do? Quickly finish, wrap up? Okay. Good. See, life is also like this. If we play it like a game, it's hilarious. And we look for it. We wait for it. But if it becomes boring, we want to move away from it. So I will try my lecture not to be boring today. Before we move on to the journey, I will thank the whole society, Balaji Society, faculty members. Is Saraswati ke prangan mein, Saraswati ke mandir mein, jitne bhi log baithe hain, I mean, I respect all that we are here to study in order to transform our lives. We are having facilitators here who will help you in transforming your lives, but finally it is up to us how much we are able to grasp. It is in the, like cricket match also, the manager or mentor Ravi Shastri, he can only guide the team. Finally, it is to the team how they work on the field, how they behave on the field, how they get the output on the field. And tell me, today India will win or not? Okay. So, not taking much time, I will continue on to my journey, looking back, but looking back only to move forward. When we look at the old days, it is not to think of past, but it is to take the learnings from past to utilize for the future. Has anybody seen this photograph earlier? Where? Somebody said Gita. That's very right. So don't you see that this is also a journey. Our life is a journey. You start from a kid. You grow. You get all kind of knowledge base. Then you convert that knowledge into actions. Whatever you aim for the life, you convert your ideas, knowledge, whatever you are grabbing from anywhere and everywhere, you are converting that into assets and then leaving behind a legacy. Isn't it? So similarly, if I convert into engineering language, I think many of you will be from engineering background, right? So I just wanted to convert that into an engineering curve. How does it happen for any individual? This is a true story of an individual, how the life goes. In the early age, we have all kind of anxiety, all kind of exploring the unexplored things. And after we get settled, we stabilize, and then until and unless we delay the negative returns area, we do. This is life, isn't it? This is the reality of life. So, what is the learning here? If we want to extend our profitability or our productivity of life, we need to increase or we need to elongate the points of maximum yield. If you look at that point, that is the time you need to inculcate new habits, new ways of thinking, or new cults. I will use this same theory in my discussion further. Hold on for now. So when I was told to share my journey with all of you, it was given a topic like from campus to journey this far. And when I was summarizing it, I thought of giving it another title. We used to see unseen passages in our early classes and we used to give a name to it. Similarly, I also gave the name. And it was Kasht Se Akash Tak. This is the story of me or anybody who wants to start his life, dream for something, work to attain, realize the dream, and then get it. So same is my story, as already briefly shared with you. I also started from a small family, joint family, did my engineering, and then look for something. In my childhood, with my maternal uncle, he asked me once, when I came first in the fourth class, what do you want as a gift? And I asked,
मुझे आप उड़ने वाला घोड़ा दीजिए, फ्लाइंग हॉर्स.
दैट टाइम ही सेड ओके यू स्टडी मोर वी विल ट्राई फॉर यू. एंड द डे आई गॉट सेलेक्टेड इन इंडियन एयरफोर्स आई सेंड हिम द इंफॉर्मेशन आई गॉट इट. बट जर्नी फ्रॉम काश से आकाश तक इट वॉज नॉट सिंपल, नॉट स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड. इट वॉज हैविंग वेरियस काइंड ऑफ थॉट प्रोसेस चेंजेस. देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन थॉट्स एंड थिंकिंग. कैन एनीबडी टेल वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन थॉट्स एंड थिंकिंग? Anybody? Yeah, please. Just one second. We'll come to you. Yeah. Okay. Great. Claps for him. You also please come up. Building on it.
Yeah.
Great. So, thoughts, simply, thoughts aate rehte hain, jaate rehte hain. Thoughts are coming every moment. It's like the waves when you sit on the shore. You see in the sea, the waves are coming up and going and coming to the shore. So, those are thoughts. Thoughts are every time, every moment, you close your eyes and you will still keep getting some kind of thoughts. Thinking is when it got inside you. It is like activities versus culture. When you continuously think about any subject, any area of your life, it becomes thinking. And when that thinking comes into your mind, that is a time when you want to go for it. For thoughts, you may not. So that's what similar thing happened for me also in this case. And the moment from the time I got thinking that I need to get something different, we worked for it and finally aimed for it, attained it. And from in that manner, I just try to capture few learnings which could be helpful for not only me, but even for all of you. And in line with the, when I was going through the core values of this society, I saw 3 D's, right? What are those 3 D's? Everybody knows. Yes. So we should know our core values, because those are the core values which are needed to deliver on the results. Results can be attained in any manner, by any other way also, but it is the core value which tell you how you need to get those values. Similarly, I try to capture my learnings also with some more D's. Okay? So here goes the story. Dream the destination. First and foremost, you need to have a dream in your life. Discover your purpose. And once you have, then desire to do it. Because until unless you have desire to do it, many people can think, but they will not succeed until unless they have done it. So, desire to do what you want to do. Beyond that, define the design. That wherever you want to go, whatever goal you want to achieve, what is the path you want to take? There is not only single path. like water from mountains to the sea goes through different paths. Similarly, there is not even one single path to attain your aim. You need to design your path. And once you have decided, declare the goal. Why you want to declare? Because once you declare your goal, you feel yourself accountable for it. Until unless you declare your goal, it's only in the mind. Once you decide and declare, then you start your journey towards it. Dare to defend against disruptions. Is there any way, I mean, in our life, disruptions will not come? It will always come, no? Like I was coming in the morning from Mumbai to this place, and we started at 9 o'clock. On the way, there were, because of the rains, heavy rains, in Mumbai itself, there were roadblocks, there were diversions. So diversions will always come. But what will happen? It will depend on your focus. Where is your focus? Your focus is on the disruptions or your focus is on the goal? Kabhi aisa ho sakta hai ki aap ghar se nikle and you say all red lights will be green, then only I will move out of my home. It's not possible. So you will start your journey, and on the way, when there are red lights, you will stop. When there are diversions, you will divert. You will find your way. But your aim will be that you have to reach your destination. You every day come to this, you people stay in hostels or you come, some of you are day scholars also? Okay. So, just think over it. If you have to move from here to Mumbai, close your eyes for 30 seconds. 30 seconds. That in the heavy rain atmosphere, you are going to Mumbai. How many have reached Mumbai? Okay. How was your journey? Front. Good. So when you think, see, some of you were thinking heavy rain. Yes or no? Some of you were thinking, maybe some of you, about Lonavala. Yes or no? I also saw in the morning a lovely place of Lonavala after crossing Mumbai. So during the Mumbai, moving out from Mumbai, it was a problematic stretch. But after Mumbai was over, it came to Ghats, Lonavala. It was quite pleasant scenario. Waterfalls everywhere. So this happens in life also. Life will not be always same. It will be mixed. And you need to enjoy the journey. You need to move from place to place, keeping both things in your hands, that everything will come in your way. Positives, negatives, or part of life. Demonstrate determination. This is what is when during the life struggle, you will find tough time. You need to show determination. And you have few live examples within your campus. Like my dear friend Anil, he is a live example of demonstrating determination in tough times. Yes, Anil? I think clap for him once. So, I am only saying the conditions are same for everyone. It is the way anybody reacts to it. That is the response which creates our future, and it depends on nobody else but only on us. Degree of direction towards destination. This is like a ship, and we all are captains of our ship. And deep inside sea, even if we change the direction of this ship by 1 degree, not much, 1 degree, end destination will change. Are you with me? So, it is your ship. How you change your direction will depend what is your destination. There is a saying in Hindi, Soch badlo, sitare badal jayenge. People who are not knowing Hindi may think it tough. I will make easy for you. Right? Soch badlo, sitare badal jayenge. Nazar badlo, kashtiyan badalne ki zarurat nahi. दिशा बदलो, किनारे बदल जाएंगे. सो देयर इज ओनली अ चेंज ऑफ डायरेक्शन एंड यू ऑल हैव कम टू दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन जस्ट अबाउट दैट. मैनी ऑफ द थिंग्स विच आई एम टेलिंग यू और एनी अदर स्पीकर हु इज कमिंग ऑन दिस डायस एंड शेयरिंग विद यू, you people must be knowing it. In today's world of internet, I mean Facebook and WhatsApp, you must be getting these kind of videos every day. It is not like you are not knowing it, but that after that knowing, how much you are utilizing it for your benefit, that will change your life. And after you reach your destination, distribute and dedicate. What do you mean by this? We have learned, and in our journey of this learning, we have support, we have full participation of our parents, of our family members, of our teachers, right? Of our friends, isn't it? So, once we reach the destination, let's not forget them. Let's support them. Let's give back to the society. Let's give back to the nation. We are becoming big. This doesn't mean we should not support others. So, our aim should be whatever we are doing, whatever we are becoming capable of. Finally, it's when it comes to our turn, we should be supporting others. Somebody has supporting us in life. Yes or no? Yes, some of the other friends or family members, parents must have supported you. So now when you come into that driving seat, you need to be supporting others. Delay the decay of depreciation. I try to capture the terms in D only. That's why you might be finding the various terms. So delay the decay of delay the decay of or depreciation. What do you mean by that? The last which I have told you, diminishing. So if you delay this diminishing or decay, you will live much more useful life. So for that, what you need to do? Any ideas from anybody? What can we do to delay that decay? We need to learn new things. We need to try new things. We need to inculcate new things. We need to continuously doing new things. And I want to share with you, till the time you are doing something new, you are young. Youth is nothing else. The person who is looking for something new, who is working for something new, who is getting new ideas, is youth. Whether he is at the age of 80 or 20. So, are you all young?
Yes, sir.
Are you all have ideas?
Yes, sir.
And are you have intention, desire to convert those ideas into actions?
Yes, sir.
Then I am honored to be in between all the young people. Thank you. Dance with dreams to defer the death. This is that whatever you want to do, do something new so that you don't die. Change is constant. And you already must have many of this information with you, how that world has been changing around us. Each of these applications, each of these products has changed our lives. But at the same time, old, if you see that floppy disk, has anybody has seen that floppy disk?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I thought nobody of you at least have seen. In our time, we used to start with floppy disk in that computer, personal computer. But those days are gone. So, if you say the times are changing, products are changing, and it will be continuously changing. The need is to discover what is changing, what is going to come up next in coming time, and getting ready for that. I say innovation and disruption, these are just two parts. Innovation is you are improving the current product, right? While disruption is replacing it with some new technology, some new product, and making the old product obsolete. Theory of reality. It is simply what you want to see is visible to you. It is your focus, what you want to observe. Visualize experience. When you want to see a positive energy in somebody, you will find that. And when you want to see a negative energy, you will find that. जब कोई अपना दोस्त होता है तो उसकी बड़ी से बड़ी कमी हमें दिखाई नहीं देती, और किसी से अगर लड़ाई हो जाती है तो राई का पहाड़ बन जाता है. इट इज लाइक दैट. सो इट इज सिंपल दैट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ स्पैक्स वी आर वियरिंग, कलर्ड स्पैक्स, वी विल सी दोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ दैट कलर. एक जनाब, वन पर्सन, ही टोल्ड हिज फ्रेंड that my neighbor's house is so bad, so dirty. He says, what happened? He says, I don't know, but from last 1 week, I am seeing his house is very dirty. Well, okay, I will tell him if you are commenting like that. So he told the other friend, yeah, your house is quite dirty from last 1 week. He said, no, not at all. My house is quite clean. Let's go together. So they went to the first friend's house, and from his window, the neighbor's house was looking quite dirty. So the third friend, who was the neighbor, he just opened the window pane, and outside, he just rubbed it with the wet cloth. And the neighbor's house became clean. So it's many times, it is not the problem with others, it is the problem how we are observing others, how we are seeing, looking at them. So there is a saying in Hindi also, Ja ki rahi bhavna jaisi. So how you perceive other is based upon your understanding, your thinking. If you see, it is how you are looking at it, isn't it? So it is depending on you how you perceive your life or anybody else's life. Anybody coming into your contact is depending on you, how you are making or breaking that relationship. So that networking is depending on you.
So what do you say in today's atmosphere? Is it economy which is struggling, or it is the kind of business models? Business models or economy? So split house. Actually, it is not the economy. It is the way we are doing business. Those kind of models are changing. If you say from economy, our country is well on its way to be fifth biggest economy of the world by 2020. And by 2030, it will become the third largest economy of the world. So economy is not going down. Only the way business models are continuing are changing. Okay, tell me, for an example, taxi drivers or auto drivers, nowadays crib about their earnings. But at the same time, Uber, Ola are expanding. So, have we reduced our moving from one place to another place? No, na? So, but what has changed? It is the change of way we are doing it. So, business models are changing, not the economy models. Similarly, so this is also kind of disruption, isn't it? So, disruption is a part of life. And some good statement I was reading when I was reading some information about this society, that problems or concerns or complexities will keep coming in our life. But it's up to us how we transform that into opportunities. And I think we all, as a professional, are nothing but transformers. You know what is the function of transformer? Science students, engineering students, anybody from engineering? What does step up transformer do? Okay. What are we doing? We also should be transforming ideas into actions, right? Adversities into opportunities. So I call upon, we are transformers.
That's again.
Are you able to hear me? Okay, so can we all say that we are transformers?
Yes,
sir. So follow with me. We are transformers.
We are transformers.
We are transformers.
We are transformers.
We will transform our lives.
We will transform our lives.
Out of me. He says, I changed my mind. I changed my mind. And now I am converting it into a picture. Clay says, you only change your thinking. You only change your thinking. But my life is changed. How? Earlier I was becoming hookah, carrying lot of coal, burning coal inside me, lot of heat inside me. But now, I'm becoming a pitcher, carrying the cold water, which will help the thirsty people. So your one thought is changing my life, isn't it? So that is what happens in life, that your thinking changes your life, and it sometimes not changes your life but somebody else's life also. So I told that kashtiyan badalne ki zarurat nahi, disha badlo, kinare badal jayenge. So you need not change your organization, you can change your thinking and you can change your path within the organization to reach any kind of destination which you want. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari and from Assam to Gujarat, from all the states, we have the fresh oxygen inside this campus. Yes? And actually, when you study in this kind of setup, one side is the learning of the subjects, whichever stream you take, pick here. But another benefit which you get is this group, this networking of you people. After the studies are over, you will move from place to place. You will be working somewhere else. I mean, somebody in some organization, other organization, but your network will be your strength. And we realized it just 3 days back. From my engineering college, we have a group now because of WhatsApp and Facebook. 3 days back, one of our dear friends, he got detected a disease, and the liver transplant was the advice from the doctor. He was in Lucknow. He is doing his own business. And he was in immediate need of support because this treatment is not economical. It's a heavy treatment. And I want to share with you, within 24 hours, the only our group of around 45 friends were able to support him through an amount of 12 lakh rupees. That is the power of networking. When you need everybody and anybody's support, your friends are your strength. Whenever you need them, they are there to support you. And in other words, on other way, you are also ready when your friends are in need of any help, you are supporting them. I said this happens in our lives also. Like in today's match, I was saying, match was when it started, after some time, this chap, Pandya, got a problem. Yes? He was out of field. And then there was a thinking that we have only 5 bowlers. What will happen? So that was also a disruption in the thinking of our team, that what will happen, but how do we accommodate or adapt ourselves to the new circumstances? And actually, speaking, these games or sports teach us in a very genuine manner these qualities of life, that how do we adapt to the changes or atrocities? How do we behave or respond in the atrocities? And same thing, if you find it is written in the religions also. In religion, it is said that whatever you have done in the past, result of that has become the circumstances of today. And how do you respond in today's circumstances? That will create your future. ये कर्म का सिद्धांत है. द फिलोसफी ऑफ कर्म सेज दिस, एंड वेदर यू गो टू भगवद गीता, वेदर यू गो टू एनी जैन रिलीजन ऑल्सो, आई हैव गॉन थ्रू द जैन रिलीजन. सो इन दैट इट इज सेड दैट कर्म, वट एवर सर्कमस्टांसिस यू हैव गॉट नाउ इन टू, वॉज द आउटपुट ऑफ योर पास्ट कर्माज. एंड नाउ इन दिस सर्कमस्टांसिस हाउ यू आर रिस्पॉन्डिंग विल बी क्रिएटिंग योर फ्यूचर. सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द बिजनेस मॉडल्स वर्सेज इकॉनमी. Yeah, we left there. So just have a look. Uber Eats, Swiggy, right? Many of Zomato, somebody said. So you are aware of them. So these examples simply telling economy is not going down. It is the way we are doing businesses. Please, with open mind, look at what is in future for us. How and which idea of ours can help us to take on to future course of journey. Same life cycle which I showed you for individual is again true for any kind of industry, any kind of product, that till the time that product is giving any kind of output or productivity, it is good. The moment it is started diminishing, it needs to be replaced with a better product, better strategy or better revenue stream. That slide which I showed you, that old things gone, new things came, is also another example that if you don't change, somebody else will change you. Yes or no?
Yes,
so better change yourself and be ahead of time, so that instead of you, somebody else need to change. Opportunities ahead in terms of industry, just sharing with you few glimpses. Trend lines are positive internationally. Subscriptions are growing in each and every part of world. Connected devices are enhancing. Same will happen for the economy also. We were discussing about the economy. Look at the GDP. Green color shows the current status, while red shows where are we going to be in 2030. We are well on our way to become world's third largest economy by 2030. And more than us, you all who are sitting here will be active participant. You will be the active participant in getting that aim. Right or wrong? And if you see the India's rate of GDP, it is growing steadily. When it comes to internet story, the internet users are also growing. And this growth rate has increased actually in last 3 years, which is leading to what? Usage. Data usage is growing by leaps and bounds. I'm not talking about one company. I'm talking about industry. I'm talking about nation. As a nation, the data usage is growing. That means, if data usage is growing, the other related streams will also be needing more and more people, talent, to manage that.
Isn't that an opportunity for all of us?
So, but we need to be ready for that.
Consumer behavior. Just sharing with you, various kind of assessments have been done and found how many people are now procuring the things online or want to go still to the stores to purchase it. So, to share with you, if I say the music, all of you must be doing it, yaar. Why should I tell you? Isn't it? You people must be doing it online. While for other things, I think suits and shirts, etc., we might be still going to the shops. Or that is also 50% now coming online. So, the way we are managing ourselves is also changing. We are, everything going to online. There are so many examples. And on the right side, you see three people, not from anybody foreign country. They are our own Indians ruling the world. I say Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. Isn't it? So, they are like us and we are like them. They were not from IIMs or they were not from IITs. One of them was there. But I mean, I am saying ideas and the self-development, it is not limited to a specific institution. Anyone who has ideas, anyone who has that hunger to succeed, anyone who has that thirst to do something new, can do it. And if he wants to do it, he can. He has that can-do attitude, he will do it. Will you all do it? See, you have recently joined this institution where you are going to get that academic as well as the other qualifications, I will say. Some qualifications can be named, some may not be named, but you will be getting that, those indirect inculcated into you, which will create a capable person out of you. This is your outlook, how you perceive, how you take that, how you grasp it and utilize it for your development. Now, we were talking about the innovations. On the left side, you see, are you going to tell them these are innovations or disruptions? Some of them are innovations, but some of them disrupted the complete market. Yes or no? So innovation and disruptions, the difference is of implementation. When you have a product or you have an industry and you are improving upon it, it's called innovation. When somebody else do it to you, it becomes disruption. You're driving a vehicle, driving a car, you're going at a speed, you get a better vehicle, innovation, but somebody else is changing the way you are driving, it is disruption. Somebody coming in your way is disruption. So, innovation and disruption. And when we talk about technology, what are the disruptions which we can convert for our benefit? These are the disruptions. Content. Big data. IoT. Cloud. Even security is a complete subject in itself. Digital, mobility. These you people will be studying them in detail. I am not going to take here the technology lecture. I know people are feel bored in these kind of interactions when we go too much of technical, right? For that classes are there. So, but I want to say it is up to us how we utilize these disruptions for our benefit. While we say disruptions, this is our capability, how we ride on the wave. We are in a sea where the tide is coming. Now, if you know how to move over the tide, how you go over the tide will help you in surviving and becoming above it. So, conditions are same for everyone, but it is how we transform ourselves. Here I call upon the transformers sitting in this room to follow with me once again. We are the transformers. We will transform our lives.
We will transform our lives.
We are the transformers.
We are the transformers.
We will transform the nation.
We will transform the nation.
We are the transformers.
We are the transformers.
We will transform the nation. So, if you look at the content, I am just giving you a glimpse. I will not go into detail. I am just telling you what kind of opportunities you will find. Each of the content provider or content distributor is an opportunity. Isn't it? This is going to be content industry. This telecom industry, it is said that in some time it is possible that telecom operator will be taken over by content companies. Google or YouTube, all these are content companies. They are so powerful, of course, because of all of us only, that they have more power than the telecom companies now. So this is an opportunity for you if you create yourself capable. You can think them as your future map. This is just to give you a glance, various parts of the content industry in which you could assume, where should I go? See, each of you has to discover your purpose. So it's up to you what you want to do. Big data. Big data, we say this is going to be the next big thing, because with kind of data, it is going to be utilized for IoT, Internet of Things. The connected devices in the world are going to increase. This is also an opportunity for all of us. If any of these industry is rising, we all are part to it. We all can become leading professionals as a part of these industries. Yes or no? So, there is no end of opportunities. Economy is not going down. New opportunities are on our way. How you want to take them is in front of us. IoT or M2M? M2M was simple machine to machine. It was location based services, etc., which was running till now, smart metering. But now with IoT, data of various entities is getting merged and utilized by various entities at the same time. This is helping our civilization. This will help all the industries, and which will help all of you also. Isn't it? If you say, talk about the word, the connected devices, they are going to increase. And out of that, if I take simple cellular IoT, that is on the right side, is also growing. And the applications, if you look at bottom, I just give you a glimpse of how, which applications, which industries are using them. So those could be lucrative, way forward industries. When we talk about future, okay, where is our future, where are the jobs, where will we go after 4 years or 3 years? These are the way forward industries available worldwide, not only in India. So if you want to become an IoT professional, you have to get through these capabilities. When I said about the learnings of my life, when you want to go on a journey, you need to analyze, you need to assess, you need to design, right? This is what about all that. You need to analyze in order to go on to journey of becoming an IoT professional, but all capabilities you need to attain while through academics or other than that. You people need to attain these eligibilities. You need to become capable in each of these fields to get onto that journey. Cloud. Cloud computing will help in big data, managing the big data. These opportunities will help you in making up your mind in which field you want to go, in which area you want to excel, and you want to create your purpose. Security in itself is a big area now. Just look at this. Digital change. How the scenario has changed in last 10 years. And you must be comparing your usage against it. What is with you? Each of you can look at that, and pattern matching is always in our minds. Whenever we see anything, we compare with our life. What is it for me? So am I doing that? So if you see smartphones, 2018, just 4 to 5 times on that. Smart speaker. I mean, these are the various areas where you will find that your technology, your working here, your studies here will help you in growing yourself. Anil had asked me to just give you a glimpse of technical information, which I thought I will give you only some glimpse of it. I don't want to go into details of that. If you want to have a detailed discussion on it, we can have a dedicated separate lecture on that. Mobility is our prime area, I'll say. And if you see in the mobility section, voice is getting reduced, data is getting ahead. That is what is the behavior which we all of us are having. Many of us, till 3 years back, or 4 years back, I'll say, were doing voice calls, SMSs. But in last 4 to 5 years, the trend has changed. WhatsApp groups have taken over. Updates between the friends is happening in a second, without any interruption from anybody else. So that is the change which has come into our lives, that has changed the pattern. Now, what is it doing? Is putting pressure on the system. Data usage is growing by leaps and bounds. Rates are coming down, I showed you in a slide. So it is putting some kind of pressure on the system that how to get the revenues. If usage is continuously growing, by without getting revenues, how will company sustain? The operators are continuing this argument internally. We all are doing internally. What do we do? How are we going to give returns on investment to our shareholders, or we use that amount to reinvest for coming technologies. So this is a discussion point which is always in the industry going on, that how do we handle these challenges. So session was supposed to be ending at 8 o'clock, right? So we have a question and answer session also. Anil, I take permission to move fast onto this so that we get onto that. 5G, there is a 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G. By the time we embrace it, 6G will also be there, right? So the industry is moving at a fast pace. The need of these kind of telecom investments is huge. This is a capex intensive industry in line with aviation. The need is to keep continuing investing into the market. We were from 2G, we went to 3G. By the time we were doing 3G, 4G came, so we had to convert the networks to, now we are converting it into 4G. By the time we do it 4G, 5G auction will come. So this is one industry where we are continuously chasing the needs of customers. In current integration, which they are sharing the world's biggest integration which we are doing, is live networks, live customers of both networks, Vodafone and Idea, are getting merged onto one network. And these are live customers. These are not using customers. Both sides, customers are using the network. It's a tedious exercise, complex exercise. We are doing it. We are halfway into it. And we hope to complete it by early March next year. Just to give you a glance on 5G, there are measurements. And what is the benefit coming out of 5G? In simple terms, the data speeds will increase. Latency will come down, which will help in for the new streams. Artificial intelligence and other streams will get benefited. Remote care, the unmanned vehicles, those all are the products which are expected to utilize that. This is just that in 5G as compared to 4G, what will happen? In 5G, you will have demand-based resource allocation, which will help to optimize the performance of 5G. Slightly technical, I move ahead. This is good slide on 5G. What is in store for you? Smart people. For smart people, there will be smart cities. So smart care, everything is smart. But let me tell you, smart, along with the smart, we should all continue to have heart. Right? While the world is becoming smart, we need not forget our surroundings, our person sitting next to us. Right? We should remember heart-to-heart talk while we become smart. Finally, the same slide once again. Is it same slide or different slide? How many say same? Raise your hands. How many say different? So it's about us. Again, that if you want to adapt the change, if you want to elongate your useful life, learn something new, think something new, create something new, be new yourself. If you think of new things, you will always remain young. Yes or no? So once again, I ask you to follow with me. What is that? So we will sing in chorus. We are. We will transform. We are. We will transform. We are. We will transform the. Third line. We are transformers. We will transform the whole world. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, say again with me. We are transformers.
We are transformers.
We will transform the.
We will transform.
Not nation. Nation to karenge hi. Uske saath saath world. So, small story for you. A potato? How many smile? An egg? And coffee beans? Three things. Three objects. Put them into hot water. Which three things? Potato, egg, and coffee beans. Put them into hot water. What will be the result? Potato will become soft, isn't it? Egg will become hard. And coffee beans? So the water is same, isn't it? The objects. Response is different. This is about us. Circumstances will be always same for everyone. 24 hours in life will be continuing for everyone. It is up to us how we respond to the changes around us and how we transform our lives to give different kind of results. Whether it is your family, whether it is your college, whether it is your university, whether it is your office, it depends on you. How you change your responses and attain different kind of conditions, different kind of positions. Just last few words. How many of you want to become successful in your life? Everyone? How many of you want to do something different in your life? So if you want to do something different, you will have to think something different. Because it is said that any activity or any work we do, first we think in our brain, right? And that thinking comes from the thoughts or thinking, whatever we have at the back of our mind, we say back of mind. So we have to change our thoughts, thinking to get something new. And here I call upon all the professionals sitting in this room that it is only you, it is only about you. How you think about yourself will change your outlook about life, about your aims, about your purpose, which will transform you into a better professional, better citizen, better of this nation, which will help not only you, but it will be an honor for your college, it will be an honor for your family, parents, everyone. So, thank you so much. So I close my discussion with few lines. I am actually fond of writings. Whenever I find time, I write words, and small poems. Majority of them used to be on telecom because I was part of that industry. But sometimes I write afresh also. Hai samay ki aisi dhar, this is not mine, which I am referring to you, is only for you. Hai samay ki aisi dhar, hai samay ki aisi dhar, ki jisme sab beh jaya karte hain. Pardon? Hai samay ki aisi dhar, ki jisme sab beh jaya karte hain. Hai samay bada balwan, prakhar parvat jhuk jaya karte hain. अक्सर दुनिया के लोग समय में चक्कर खाया करते हैं, लेकिन कुछ ऐसे होते हैं जो इतिहास बनाया करते हैं. एंड आई नीड ऑल ऑफ यू टू बिकम ए सक्सेसफुल प्रोफेशनल. आई वांट यू टू डू सर्टेन गुड थिंग्स इन लाइफ and then give back to the society, give back to the other people, support others who are not capable, make them capable, so that while you will stand in this life with as a successful and you will be standing on this dais like I am standing here, I want each of you after some time coming here in this college and addressing your juniors as a successful professional. Thank you.
Now the house is open for question and answer session.
Sir, I want to ask you about Vodafone. Yes. Vodafone has already lost 35 million subscribers in last 3 months.
Yes.
The net debt has rose to around 1,14,760 crores.
Yes.
Interest is increasing day by day.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Also, in the month of April, it has already lost 1.5 million subscribers. So I want to ask you, how Vodafone will overcome this disruption created by some other company?
So as I told you, disruption is part of life. When we created this Vodafone idea, that juncture was quite difficult for both the companies. And the reality was, there were three or four companies who already moved out of this business in last 2 years. We came together to fight it out. And the basis of this merger was to reduce our cost structure. How are we reducing our cost structure? See, in business, the profitability depends on two things. Top line, bottom line. Yes or no? So top line is gaining on revenues. Gaining on customer base, new customers, using your strengths, and another is reducing your cost. So after the merger, first focus of ours was to reduce on the cost side. So what have we been doing from last 1 year is merging both the networks. So earlier, one cell site of Vodafone, one cell site of Idea, both side by side was supporting the customers. Now what we are doing, single tower supporting both the customers. So that kind of transformation is helping us in reducing our cost. Already in last 2 quarters we have been able to bridge the cost structure. A company will continue maintain its continuity the moment it has EBITDA positivity. EBITDA is, you know, I think all of you must be knowing what is EBITDA. No. EBITDA is earnings before
interest.
Yes. So our first focus was on the saving the cost. Now, as far as you are saying about the customer's journey, so I will touch upon that also. See, in the customer's side, there were customers who were having multi-SIM. One customer having 2 SIMs. One of Airtel, another for Vodafone, or one for Vodafone, another for Jio, or one for Vodafone and Idea also. Must be. So, what is happening in last from the time of December or January, when the 35 rupees were added as a essential monthly fee, the customers who were using multi-simming, they were using only for incoming calls, not for outgoing, because it was an old SIM, they were continuing with that. Those majority of them have moved out, which were not using the network. Our focus will be on the revenue earning subscribers. So the moment we have to continue with our revenue earning subscribers, which are giving us revenue, our positivity will not go away. So our focus is currently on one side, the unification of networks, which will reduce our cost. At the same time, expand the 4G footprint, give them the best quality. Wherever we are, let's give them best quality with both networks now merging together, the spectrums are getting merged. So if Idea was having 5 megahertz and Vodafone was having 7 megahertz, together it becomes 12 megahertz for the customers. So that kind of benefit, which will enhance the experience of end customers. If we are able to sustain with our high-end customers who are giving us revenue with that kind of data story, which was showing that data is growing, internet is growing, everything is going to grow, IoT is going to grow, right? The story, future story, is going to become positive. That is what we are working for. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay. Anyone else? Yeah. Okay. Before that, I think he had raised his hand. Yeah, please go ahead.
In today's news, there's a news stating as Voda names Tata Communications CEO as new base, right? Vinod Kumar.
Yeah.
What change will he bring to Voda?
See, that is the Voda Group, Vodafone Group. Not in Vodafone India. Okay, so these are the changes which keep on happening. Industry professionals are moving from one side to another side. That does not change the culture of a company. Culture of company or values of companies continue. Okay, and Tata is also a great company. We are taking the intelligence, or we are taking the professionals who will help us in the bigger growth. That Vodafone news which you are saying is for the Vodafone group. So he will support in growing the group. India may be part of it. Okay. Yeah, you were saying something.
Hello, sir. My name is Subodh. Sir, as you said, telecom sector is always a chasing sector for technology.
And chasing sector.
Chasing. It's always growing as far as the technology is changing, and we are moving 4G to 5G, and it's beneficial for AI and IoTs. Yes. So what is in it for telecom market? Because the data usage is increasing, quality of data is increasing,
yes.
But similarly on the other side, cost is also decreasing. So yes. What is in it for telecom sector?
So the rates are going down, but volume is going up. Net, if volume is going up, it on one side poses challenge for the technical side to enhance their networks, which we are doing now, like from 3G to 4G we are expanding, and what equipment now we are deploying for doing the 4G is compatible for 5G, so that when the auction happens and next time spectrum is purchased, we need not change the network again. Because network change is not an easy thing. Live networks getting replaced with new equipment, it takes time, money and energy of organization. So what we are doing currently is changing with the new equipment, new technology, which will take us to 5G also. That readiness. To your question, yes, it becomes some kind of challenge for telecom. For technical teams, okay, but at the same time, to support customers in long run, like you are seeing the IoT is, or big data, whatever you say, it is, end result will be the data usage will growing. 5G In 5G, you saw that latency is coming down, right? And your data throughputs are increasing. 1G, speeds are also coming into picture. So network expansions will happen, which we are banking on, that with that kind of massive growth on data, the benefits come out. Okay.
Are you satisfied? Or you have any other query?
Okay. Anyone else? Yeah, please.
So you
go to next, that corner. Those are neglected corners. Yeah, please.
So you just said about the cost. So coming to the cost, as I know, Idea and Vodafone are not the asset-light model. They are still working on towers, whereas other networks have been working on the satellites. So one is that thing where the cost increases. And another thing is, since last 6 to 8 months, the capitalization of Vodafone and Idea is coming down and down.
Yes.
As the market capitalization is coming down and down, the debt increases. And increase in debt lead to increase in cost. And with the low subscriber, how the company is going to sustain in coming years?
It's a good question. And the answer will only be told by the time. Okay. The only our effort currently in the organization is to sustain. Whatever you are saying is, I am not saying it is wrong, it is right. What is the current scenario? It is a difficult scenario. We are going through turbulent times, but at the same time, the team at Vodafone Idea is well geared to take it forward. I mean, I was telling you that ship is inside the sea, right? And when you are on a journey, you get turbulent times also. So it's to the team how they keep it intact against those turbulences. If they are able to carry that ship through that turbulences, they are safely home. Isn't it? If not, they are not home. So whatever, this is the fight of existence. To be true with you, this is a fight of existence, and the kind of opposition we have, it's tough challenge. But the currently we are doing, like on one side we are focusing on the cost reductions on our side, on other side we are expanding the network footprints, 4G, enhancing our services. That is all the way where we want to keep our customers. The benefit, other benefit which we have with us is Vodafone is a global player, unless others. So all kind of latest technologies, latest edge, whatever you say, these are available to us. Expertise is available to us. So whatever kind of support we need from outside world is available to us. So we are working it out together and taking it forward.
May we have the last question?
It's how you look at it. Problems are always there. एक बात बताइए आप लोग चाय पीते हैं ना सब लोग तो 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 चाय के ऊपर अगर मलाई आ जाती है तो क्या करते हैं हटा देते हैं ना चाय तो पीते हैं ना फेंकते तो नहीं है तो यही है चाय है मलाई आ गई आपको हटाना पड़ेगा और पीना पड़ेगा So, as far as recruitments are concerned, so currently when the two companies merged together, Manpower also merged together. So there were certain roles for one role there were two people, one from Vodafone side and another from Idea side. So there was some kind of restructuring of organization which was done to adapt the new organization
for a new journey. For example, some of us continued for operations
in the circles.
Some of us took over the responsibility of integrating the two networks. Because it is not that we are switching off the networks and then doing integration and then bringing it for the customers. Because customers are continuously using those networks. So, there was one team who has been supporting the operations at ground level, and another team who is working along with the vendors to slowly and steadily change those networks, to upgrade those networks, transform those networks for modern technologies. Okay? Any other? That side. Yeah, please.
This would be a last question of this session.
Good evening, sir. My name is Ashish. Sir, my question is, while merging Vodafone India and Idea Cellular, they have 2.35 lakh kilometers of fiber cable network, and rather than Reliance Jio have over 3 lakh kilometers of fiber network, and also they have 1 lakh towers. How you look to overcome that challenge, or is this opportunity to increase the market? And sir, another question is there any effect on the employment rate?
Second question
is there any effect on employment rate while merging that two companies?
So merging of companies certainly up to some extent affects the manpower. Reason is you have 100 from one company, you have 100 from another company. To run the new company, you don't need 200 people. The same company. If you are running the same company with same kind of streams, same kind of business streams, you may need 150. So 50 may be surplus. But if you want to expand, if you want to move on, get onto new streams, if you want to get into new areas, you can utilize those people. Right? For example, I take from away from technical side, I take from sales side. There were sales people who were from Idea, there were sales people who were from Vodafone in the same territory they were working earlier. After the merger, this is the, because the revenues are growing into that areas, they have been given, their territories are rearranged. The M-Pesa or Idea Money, those kind of opportunities are coming their way. Or the new technologies like IoT. See, IoT, Vodafone was the first operator who started this IoT interactions with industry. RevaCar, the remote control that was started through Voda only. So those kind of new entities where we are able to get the opportunities for new streams, that will help in growing the job opportunities also. So opportunities are not less. It is only if even if companies are merging, the overall volume or overall customers are not coming down. But you were saying that Vodafone customers are going down or something like that. Those may be only non-paying customers who has already multi-SIM. I mean, two SIMs or three SIMs. So, ek SIM band kar diya, dusra SIM chal raha hai. Like that. So, overall, as far as physical customers are concerned, they are only growing. Because all once somebody has used a mobile, is there anybody in this room who has left the mobile? No, I will not use from today onwards. Is there anybody? No? Okay. How many of you were not having any mobile with you 2 years back? One, two, very few. How many of you are not having mobiles 5 years back? How many will not have any mobile after 2 years from now? After 2 years from now, how many of you will not have mobile? All of you will have, right? So, in other words, mobile industry is not going down. Users are not going down. Users are only going to increase. Leave the companies. Let's talk about the opportunities. If we want to focus on opportunities, please focus on opportunities. It is your focus. Where are you focusing? Like I told, I was coming from Mumbai to Pune. If I was focusing on the obstructions on my way, I may not be a happy person. But my aim was to meet you all. Right?